the biggest looks we had didn't do anything. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's
like I was telling somebody the other day, we talked about it, but we went on Steve Harvey.
Mm-hmm.
Bro, we packed up thousands of books. Showtime. I'm talking about we going
at the Apollo.
Bro, yeah. This was Steve Harvey. Daytime show was booming.
Yeah,
not the, not
sure.
The morning show, the TV show.
Yeah, yeah.
Booming. And we packed up thousands of books, bro. I'm a pre-packed, ready to go. Just all you gotta do is slap, as soon as they order them, slap the label, we out of here. Show came out. We sold 12 books.
What?
Bruh, hold on. Listen to this. I told somebody we was doing 10 a day anyway.
Right.
So on a random day.
Might have been two.
It might have been two.
No, listen to what I'm telling you. And like I said, and I want to get this conversation started around, you know, like really putting yourself on, right? Because it's this concept of put me on, put me on. Hey, here go my mixtape. Here go that, put me on.
Yeah.
And it's so crazy because we go on what we thought was the big, like, we might have been waiting on this our whole career. Like, yo, this is it. Like, all right, cool, it ain't Oprah yet, but Steve is the biggest thing out. And no disrespect to Steve. Steve did everything he was supposed to do.
Yeah.
Matter of fact, Korshawn, see if you could pull that up. Eric Thomas on Steve Harvey show.
Yeah, Steve gave me like three different sets.
Oh, bro. Oh, wow. No. Yeah. It was, he did Q&A segments. Oh, yeah. He held the book up.
Oh, yeah, Steve held the book up.
Bro, we sold 12 books.
Mm.
We was already selling 10. We sold 2 extra books. And I was like, bruh, by that time I already knew, but it's not what you think. You know what I'm saying? Like, in order to engage with an audience and be able to have something genuinely that they can connect with, you can't just have an individual say, here, go.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Like, exactly
if it was that easy, Memphis Bleek would have been the number one rapper. And shout out to Bleek. Like, I actually, you know, he had a couple records I like.
Yeah.
But I'm saying, like, that was Jay-Z's guy. I'm talking about, he was like, this is the one, this the one, this the one. But even Jay-Z, as powerful as he is, couldn't just co-sign somebody into success. You know what I mean? And so I think that's powerful when you think about, like, putting yourself on or when you're viewing how entrepreneurship should work. So talk about all of y'all, like, when you came to that understanding of, oh, okay, E, we'll start with you. You're the elder statesman, but like, oh, okay, like, even back in the day, like, think back when you first started, when Cass was like, oh, E, I'm going to do this for you. I'm going to do that for you. Or maybe you looked at somebody and it was like, yo, put me on your this, or I need to be a part of your platform.
Well, I feel like Maul right now, you know, how Maul would say, I never had that mindset.
Yeah.
And I think I didn't have it because entrepreneurship wasn't a thing when I started.
Mm-hmm.
So wasn't nobody putting nobody on.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? And then I saw King, and I saw all the people that was with King, and none of them really didn't get put on like King got put on.
Yeah.
And whoever was running with X didn't get put on like X got put on.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? And so I always, you know, from my era looking on, nobody had really, you know, I wasn't in the entertainment business, so nobody I knew, and then I followed speakers and authors. So none of them got put on by nothing but what they did. Now, I will say this, though. This was a revelation for me because I want to put people on.
Mm-hmm.
I might have been the dude trying to put people on, like literally trying to give people my stage and pray that they blow up immediately after getting on my stage.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the things that I realized, I ain't going to say that because people take it at the wrong. Some people in our inner circle could take it the wrong way. But I'm going to say this. Your fan base, you know, and I just say fan base because to Jeff's point, you got to work these days.
Yeah.
So people ain't really just following you on the, you know, the excitement no more. It's like you didn't pour it into them some kind of way. Free content.
Yep.
You done some conferences.
Mm-hmm.
You done a whole bunch of stuff. Showed them how to do content.
Yeah.
They came to your little networking event. Like it ain't like back in the day, they just watch a video. And so one of the things that I realized is that you can't borrow somebody's fan base.
Mm-hmm.
Like you can't borrow it.
Mm-hmm.
Even if just put me on, it would only be the people that he introduced me to that feel like there's something specific that I can do for them outside of what he's doing.
Mm-hmm.
That's going, it ain't gonna be like, just like, hey, did my boy E buy his book?
Yep.
They would either had to already been rocking with me or feel like, oh, okay, just, I need that, not on the strength of just. So that's one of the things, you know, I just say in the first round is that I realize people get it twisted. You can't borrow somebody's, people's loyalty to somebody else.
Right.
Or you can't borrow their credibility. Mm. Like, you can't borrow that. People will judge you off your work.
Yep.
You know, like, now you might get one, check my boy out. Mm. But then once they check you out, it's like, no, you about to get judged on your legitimate, like, selfish, what can I get from them?
Yep.
And if they don't feel like they can get something from it, whether paid or free, I just noticed that, you know, people like, you know, I'm out.
Either one of y'all?
Nah, I mean, just right what he was talking about, your work, man. It's your work. Unfortunately and fortunately, I worked around a bunch of people in the police department that couldn't put me on outside of the realm of the police department.
Right.
And the culture in the police department is all about putting somebody on, but it's all like you just got to say, they putting you on is, hey, I got the security contract and I want you to come stand here every day for 4 hours and work.
Right.
And I'm going to pay you $15 an hour. Right. But the company, Walmart, Home Depot, paying me $25 an hour, so I'm making $10 off of you. So therefore, your value is what I can make off of you.
Yeah. Mm.
You know, but just in my life, I had to step outside, bro. Yeah. It wasn't nobody, and I'm trying to think, when you was talking about this, I was like, man, who put me on? Like, what does that even look like?
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not talking about, like, what I'm going through now in life. I'm talking about in the beginning. Like, and really, when I was sitting back thinking, bro, I had to put myself on. Like, meaning that, especially in real estate, like, I had to, it was people that able to guide me.
Yeah.
But that's not putting me on.
Yeah, no.
You know what I'm saying? Nobody ever gave me anything. Yeah. And I think for the people that's looking to so-called, quote-unquote, put them on, like, what does that mean to you? Like, what's that real definition of put you on?
Put you on is like, yo, I got a talent or a service, put me in front of your people and it's going to blow up.
I think
up. Like,
missing,
you know what I'm saying?
Something when you do that, right?
For sure.
You missing all of the, I go back to, you know, prime example, what you did with Toby. You and E had such a Rolodex of people that could have instantly put Toby on. But if these people, if you guys would have missed that process, right, having him go through the process that he went through over the years, would he still be the Toby that we know today?
Yeah, and I'm saying, I feel you, but bump that, put me on.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I don't need to learn the lesson.
Well, yeah, that's what most people think.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? I'm just being real. Like, I feel more on the lesson. That's great. But if you just put me on, I'd have made 50
but
million.
But you don't think the putting you on, to me, putting you on is like somebody going to the doctor just going to have surgery as opposed to going every day.
Yeah.
I got you, but you're missing out on that.
No, and I'm not.
It's something that's being built.
Oh, yeah. I'm saying that's because you own some whatever you own.
You know what I'm saying? But it's something in that process.
Oh, I feel what you're saying, but I'm saying, bruh, I said this in my sermon the other day. I know gazillions of people that will take a check for not doing work.
Yeah.
I don't know many people that will work and not take a check.
Yeah.
Like, I'm not sure I know a lot of people that's like, hey, don't even worry about it. I work for you for free for a year. Don't even worry about it. And I ain't even tripping. But I know a lot of people that take a check for a year and not do no physical work for it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, they're not going to be like, bro, I am between me and you, bro. You didn't pay me for 4 months and I ain't do nothing.
Facts.
You feel what I'm saying? Yeah. It's like, I got people now that are on a, what do you call it? It's like a retainer.
Yep.
Yeah.
And if I don't call and say nothing, they may not do nothing.
Mm-hmm.
So I feel what you said, but the average human is not going to go, I'm going to work for free and learn all the lessons and grow and blow. And one day I will have a year full of free lessons that's going to take me to the promised land. No. Cats like, blow me up. And so I agree with you.
Yeah.
But I'm saying a lot of people would, you know, a lot. And I didn't put nobody on. But I did have an opportunity, QDZ, whatever the radio show was called. They shut the radio show down for an hour for me.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Unheard of. The boss didn't even want to do it. I don't even know how QDZ convinced them.
By shut down, meaning like they didn't go to commercial.
No music.
No music.
No music, nothing. They just did a whole hour straight.
Of ET.
Yeah.
That's
so
it.
But was that a put on? But you was already, so in my mind, put on.
No, he about to say, I'm saying going
I put,
somewhere else.
So I gave Toby a chance to get, like, okay, Toby, they put me on, ain't no music. We're going to play your single for the whole Philly to hear and hopefully, you know, whatever. You know what I'm saying? So I was hoping, by doing that,
yeah,
that
Barry was Gordy be, was going. Barry Gordy, you know, was signing the Motown.
You feel me? That's what I was thinking. So I really, yeah, I did it going, yo, Tobe Dope. So Tobe Dope, they calling me. I got an hour. I ain't gonna be selfish. I'm gonna give Tobe. Now I can't say that didn't move the needle at all.
Yeah.
But I tell you, from the time Tobe blew up, from when we was on that hour, that was a long time.
Years.
Yeah.
Didn't, right? And Justin, go ahead, get in there. But go ahead, actually.
Now, I would say, I don't know if I thought that, somebody could
come
put
on,
me
Justin,
on.
Don't leave me out.
But I'm going to say
I thought we was getting put on.
No, but I'm going to say I did think. Because in my business, it would be like, I'm thinking I'm going to sign up somebody that's going to blow me up.
I like that.
So I'm like, okay. Yeah. All right, man, if I can just find the next person that's just like this guy over here.
Was it going to be on the left for you or the right?
That's what I'm saying. I'm like, either one. Yeah. It didn't matter because I didn't have to decide. You know what I'm saying? Where are you at? And I'll be over here building a business like, man, you could be just like this guy. Yeah. And then eventually it hit me one day. I was like, no, just you got to be that dude.
Mm-hmm.
Like, instead of you trying to hope you sign up the person as that dude.
Yep.
Become. You got to be the person that is that person. Mm-hmm. Now, here's the other thing I kind of think with E is like, there are people that don't look like us that do get put on.
Yeah. Because
they run the companies, the kids go to school, and they put them on in the spot. Yep. You know what I'm saying? So I think eventually as more of us do well and we create companies that can employ people, I think that is going to be more of a reality if people have the skills. But yeah, I think for me personally, it was that transition of like, okay, you know, yep, you do need the mentor. But at the end of the day, bro, you got to go make it happen yourself.
Yeah. And I think that's the danger, I think, when I'm speaking about it. You're right. Some people do get put on, right?
Like,
the danger isn't when you start relying on it.
Yeah.
Or when you start thinking that that's going to happen.
You feel entitled about it.
Right, exactly.
Like, man,
bro, I tell people all the time, oh, bro, you see how talented, I'm dope, bro. You can put me, I'm like, it's not what you think. Yeah. I'm like, we went on Steve Harvey and Only So, like, we didn't get put on. It's like with some of the biggest names, you think I'm about to put you on one podcast episode and you out of here, that's it? It's like you have to have something built into, you know, to E's point earlier about Tobe, as crazy as it was, I knew we couldn't put Tobe on. But what we could do is give him the information. Yeah. And if you want to follow the blueprint, right, that I sent, that's cool. So I could put you on the blueprint, but you got to put yourself on. Yeah.